Hey guys, welcome back to another Unfiltered Gamer Kickstarter board game review. Today's game up on the tabletop is called Thug Life. Thug Life is for 2 to 6 players. It takes about 45 minutes to play the game, and it's for ages 16 and up. In the game Thug Life, you're playing as a crime boss. You're going to have your own basic turf, along with your own specific type of gang, and of course you're going to have rides on homies as well. In the game, you're going to be taken to the streets to earn respect and cash. You can get 13 respect before anybody else. You're going to win the game. You'll be using cards, like these street cards here, to gain specific bonuses, along with dealing with drama cards that can happen throughout the game. Not only that, but there's also going to be cops that are going to be showing up to try and mess with you and stop you from doing exactly what you need to do to gain that respect. You're going to be using dice to attack them, along with gaining specific unique homies to kind of help you along the game. Don't forget also to throw in your pit bulls to protect your hood, along with a bunch of other stuff. Anyway, that's the basic idea of Thug Life. Let me show you what the components of the game are, and then we'll talk about how you play a turn. This is Thug Life and everything you get in the game. Now, first of all, every single player is going to get 9 thugs, and there is 9 different types of gangs in the game. Each player will also get one of these to reference how much respect they have. You're also going to be receiving money that you can use throughout the game, along with 2 different types of die, one for the cops, one for yourself, and of course, unique homies that you'll find throughout these street decks here. You've also got some pit bulls here you can use to protect your hood, and the hood cards itself, or the hood boards itself, which are going to show you what you have in your stash, along with your turf, your rides, and of course your unique homies. Everybody's going to start off with 3 Thug Life cards, and this drama deck will go here, and eventually throughout the game they're going to be revealed and things are going to happen on the streets. You're also going to be getting this first player marker here, which is going to indicate who starts the game off, some of these cards here, which is going to show you player references, along with some cop standees, and of course the game box itself. All right, let's talk about how to play. Now, to start the game Thug Life, you're going to simply take 1 color of a gang. You're going to be basically getting 9 different meeples, along with 3 street card and, of course, your player reference. You'll also be having 6 of your guys go inside your stash, along with $1, and 3 of them will be out in the front yard. You're also then going to make sure everybody else has that and choose a player to start the game with. You'll be using this player token to indicate which person is going to start, and the game begins. You'll use this player reference card to not only understand the street phase as well as the draw phase, but also the different cheat sheets of the card types and the resources. In general, though, they're going to be taking 3 actions a turn and then passing your turn to somebody else. The three actions that you can take, these are the 5 different aspects you're going to go. So you can either A, jump in, which is simply moving one of your thugs into one from your stash out into your hood. You can grind by placing a thug from your hood into the streets and also get a buck. You can upgrade your hood by playing one of these cards like a van or like taco blenders, or simply playing one of these unique homies into your hood. You can also pick a fight by simply taking this red die here, along with choosing a target and assigning thugs and attacking with this die to try and defeat them. You can gain basically respect by doing that. You can attempt a crime, basically playing a card that has a little switchblade on it that will also net you points as well as respect and other stuff. Or there's also free actions, and free actions are pretty simple. You're gonna have like the gun cards and the exclamation mark cards. These are instants or cards that you can use in combination with cards that require an action. After you're done doing that, you make sure you discard any number of cards, and then you draw 3 cards. You have to have 3 cards at the end of your turn, I believe. But no matter what, you draw 3 cards at the end of your turn, and then passes play, and players will continue to do that. Every round, a drama card is going to get drawn up to, I believe, 3, and these things are going to change the game. Maybe you'll have a house party, or a gang war, or a riot, a gangbang, a truce, so on and so forth. And the play will continue until basically something unique happens, in which there's no cops left on the streets, or somebody has all of their thugs out into the streets. That's going to basically have a set change, in which everybody's going to go back to 3 cards. All of their guys in the streets are going to return back to their home, and a couple other things will happen as well. But basically refreshes the game whenever that occurs to make it continually be fair and balanced for everybody to play. And you just can continue going like that, playing cards, trying to gain respect. You can do drive-bys, basically making your opponents lose respect and you gaining respect. You can fight the cops to gain to respect, but if you don't, bad things happen when you fight the cops and lose. Or you can even attempt to just simply go and attack people out there in the streets and whatnot. There'll be different drama cards that will do that as well. And that's the basic idea of the game, using this kind of action-based movement, going around, having a little bit of area control, a little bit of take that. Let's go ahead and show you the setup of the game, as well as a couple turns and the different actions you can take and how the drama cards work and cleanup works. So now back to the game and what I had to set it up. So as you see, there's two players here we'll be using. We're going to go ahead and have these guys start off, and then these guys will be second. We revealed the first drama card at the start of the round, and this one says Cruisin'. The start of each player's turn, or each boss's turn, bosses get to draw one card, and then at the end of each round, bosses that have a vehicle in the streets gain one thug and one respect. These stars indicate respect. These circles indicate wheels, basically, which are cars, and of course, this symbol here is cards. All of that can be found over here on this handy-dandy little cheat sheet here. You're also going to have your three cards you start with, the three street cards, a single dollar, six of your thugs in your stash, three in your hood, and of course your drama card. Make sure you start with two cops in the streets, and whenever a shift change happens, that's when these guys will also reset. Everything else should be offside the board, and everybody else should have a player reference card. We went ahead and set it up so that everybody's going to be starting at one respect. You have the yellow guy here at one and the purple guy here at one as well. And the game is going to begin. Just move those dice aside. The first player can go ahead and start, and he's going to get to take three actions like it shows on this card here. He could choose if he wants to do A, jump in by adding a thug from his stash to his hood. That would be an action. He could choose to do B, which is grind, which is move a thug from your hood to the streets, and then you get to take a dollar. And dollars are important because at the end of during a player's turn, if they have 3, 6, 9, so on and so forth, for every accumulation of $3, they're going to score respect throughout the game. So that's important to have that. Upgrade your hood. You can simply play a card from your hand. For instance, this is your vehicle. You can simply play it on your rides area. You can choose to play a location on your turf. And you can choose to play homies over here, which are going to have unique abilities. And you actually take one of their unique figures and add them to your hood, which can be used. Most times, you're going to be able to use these cards like this Taco Benders here. You can simply add a dollar and add a thug to your hood, and then you flip this card over, and cards don't get flipped over until a shift change. You can take vehicles from your rides into the streets or also into other players' hoods, so that's important to note. You can go ahead and choose to pick a fight, which is you're going to choose a target and assign thugs. So if I want, I can say I'm going to take these two thugs, and I'm going to also choose to use this arson card here. So just choose these two cards, and maybe I want to choose to add like a shotgun or something like that, which says add an extra damage to my red or my black roll, and I can re-roll the first shields, because you don't want shields, because shields are bad, and then you would discard this card, so you can do that. And if you can beat that player, you're going to actually be able to take respect from them on the occasion, as well as gaining respect when you fight the cops. You can also choose to participate in a crime, which is a lot like this. You would add these guys here. You could add any bonus cards. And then you would choose a X controlled by a boss, and if successful, destroy that X. And then, of course, if you don't know what that is, you can go ahead and look at here, and it says turf. You would then gain a respect for doing that. Like I said before, the free actions are like the flare gun or the gun, exclamation point, and then you could always convert a buck into a card if you need to. After that, you would go into your draw phase. You discard any cards you want and draw three cards. And then what happens is, and the next player gets to take their turn as well. They get to bring their guys in. They can simply use their cards to attack. We got cards like, let's say here, we got this SMG. This is basically an instant that lets you add a damage, just like the last one before it. Mug, this is a crime. It says if you're successful, you get a dollar and one additional action, and it only requires you to get one, so it's not very difficult to do. And then a Molotov cocktail that adds two. So maybe they would want to do that, maybe they wouldn't. They could spend their dollar to get an extra card if they wanted to as well. Here, they play this card here. This is a ride. This one says, drive by with up to four figures. Add a damage to the result of your die and ignore one of these death symbols here. Death means instant. So you have the different rolls of the die here. That's an instant kill. These are one and two damage. Here's two kills. And then, of course, these are cop symbols, which you definitely want to avoid no matter what die you are rolling. And you're always going to be putting stuff here on your locations that'll symbolize. You only have one of each different type. After all that goes, after all, everybody has taken their three actions, then the round is going to be over, and a drama card is going to be revealed. Another one will be put out, and this one says at the start of their turn, bosses may place one thug on the dead homies. If you do, you gain a respect. So you can go, I'm going to put one of these guys on dead homies because I respect dead homies, and then I can actually just go up. And all bosses can choose to do that as long as this is in play. A shift change can happen as well, because let's say you choose to fight the cops and you kill them, in which case all the guys from the streets are going to go back into your hood, and you would also make sure you have three cards. It would basically refresh the board. You would also put two more cops back onto the board. That happens only after the round is over, and only if one of two conditions are met. Either A, a player has nothing here, none of their homies are here, or yeah, none of their, I guess their thugs are in here, or B, if there's no cops in the streets, that would also refresh the drama cards as well. And also, the person with the most respect is going to take the first player marker. So in this case, if he was over here, he would take this, and the game would continue. Like I said before, you can gain respect from getting the currency, from doing drive-bys. Players can lose respect, and you can gain respect. You can gain respect from doing crimes, as well as choosing to fight other players, and even getting to respect from the cops. And the game's going to continue going across the board. You're using this card as a discard pile over here. And once somebody gets to 11, the only way they can get to 12, or sorry, the only way they can get to 13, this is how you win the game, is if you do a drive-by and you're successful. And there has to be guys there. If you fight a turf, or if you fight the turf that has nobody there, they're just going to lose respect and you can't gain one. So you have to actually go ahead and fight somebody and win, because you don't want any cowardly thugs. You want to actually show that you're the most dominant of the bunch. And that's the one way to win. It's kind of like Munchkin in that aspect, where you actually have to put forth the effort, and you can't just simply go up a level by having $3 or by simply playing a card and rolling die. Now, of course, players can die instantly with these different die rolls and whatnot, but they're basically to be used for either a crime or to be used as when you want to pick a fight. Turf and everything else is going to refresh too whenever the board resets, so that's another aspect as well. You can gain pit bulls. These guys come from the Thug Life deck, and they basically count as separate units that can be used for certain things, mainly for defense on your hood. But that's the basic idea of the game Thug Life. You're simply going around doing your actions, drama cards are popping up, you're gaining respect by fighting people, doing drive-bys, all that kind of stuff, and also trying to hold your respect as much as possible. You can be helping out with the dead homies, you know, paying your respects. You're going to be dealing with swap meets, car washes. What else? Truces. So sometimes that you can actually have less fighting going on. But that's the idea. So let's go ahead and talk about it, along with a couple caveats and what I think about the game Thug Life. All right, so before I get with my review, I'm going to talk about a couple caveats, and the first one being about combat, which I didn't explain too much, but it's pretty simple. In general, you're going to send your homies, you're going to send any additional cards like the crime card, along with ascending any bonus cards, like, I don't know, this any of the flare guns, shotgun, these kind of things that will give you additional attacks or rerolls, that kind of stuff. And it's going to be a comparison. So if you go and fight somebody in their turf, it'll be their dudes versus their cards versus your dudes and your cards. You'll be rolling a specific type of die, and it tells you on the on your little sheet here which one you roll. So for the picking a fight with somebody, you roll the red die, they roll the red die. If you roll a skull, that means that they're going to lose one of their guys. It just dies. If you roll two skulls, two of their guy dies. And the powers, the one and two, is just simply adding to your total combat value. Now, when you remove guys from their side of the field, if they had five and you had five and you started out and you rolled a die and you rolled a two skull, they would lose two dudes. And if they rolled a single power, then that means that they would only get one. So they would actually be down one. So you'd be five and they'd be four, in which you'd win the combat and you can gain a respect. They'd lose respect. And the same would go for whenever you're committing the crimes. So you're just going to simply roll this die here, which doesn't have any kills. You can only get power, or you can get these shields. Now, shields are bad, because that means that if you're doing a crime and you get a shield, then your crime fails and you have to go to the streets. You add a cop whenever you roll a shield, no matter what you're doing, and you fight the cops with whatever you have. And if you lose, your guy can die. If you win, all the cops get removed. If you're fighting a combat against another player and you roll the cop die, then that is going to make a cop go to the street, and you're also not going to get any bonuses. And if both of you roll cop dies, that's really bad too. You have to fight the cops, so be careful with that. That being said, that is the basic aspect of combat. It's just simply who has the most power, as well as if you roll skulls, somebody might die. There's quite a few thug cards. You got shotguns, police, backup, grenades, moving bricks, rent-a-cops, all the different unique characters that all do different things. Sometimes they're going to score you money, sometimes they're going to help you with fighting, sometimes they're like little assassination kind of guys, and then of course a bunch of crime cards that tell you what you need to roll in order to win. Like, for instance, if we have money laundering right here, if successful you get $2 and you get two cards. This is a tech crime. You can't use any vehicle or use any gun when attempting the crime, and you need a three or higher, so that is important to note. Nevertheless, so one thing about Thug Life, well, first of all, this game has a theme that is involving, like, I don't know what you want to call it, like, crime and like drugs and all that kind of stuff. So if you don't like that kind of theme, you're not going to like this game. It's, I mean, obviously the game's called Thug Life, so you probably shouldn't even be watching the video if you don't like that. But if you don't mind that, or if you even like that aspect where you got your homies and you got your crew and your crib and moving around, doing all these kind of things, it kind of gives you a little like in-depth idea of what it's like for this type of, I don't even want to call it, this type of scene, right? I mean, it happens a lot here in California. There's a lot of this kind of shootings and all that kind of stuff, a lot of terrible things that go on. This kind of gives you a little taste of that. But it doesn't bother me all that much. I don't mind it. I like the aspect of it provides a new and interesting theme I've never actually played before. And it has the mechanisms of like a, it's kind of like an action-based take that kind of game, and where you're going to be trying to get your thugs out of your stash into your turf to move them around and basically do different actions. You're trying to gain respect. It has a Munchkin-esque feel to it, which you're trying to get to that 13-point ratio. Dealing with the cops when you're rolling these dice can be kind of frustrating because sometimes you might not get the die roll you need, but that's the luck involved in the game. Most of it involves strategy, using these cards in order to do crimes, in order to go attack your other players, and of course drama cards changing the way the game is played. The reset is nice too. Whenever there's no cops or whenever somebody has all their guys off of their board, then the game's going to reset, which is cool. I like that aspect. All the artwork is good. I really, really like the artwork. I like the fact that you can choose between miniatures in the campaign. You can back the miniatures, or it has a simple standees for people who don't want to spend all the money on extra miniatures. The entire game is functionally really nice. I enjoy the take that aspects, but it can be a bit mean. If you don't like the theme, if you don't like mean games, probably not for you. If you like that take that mean take that aspect, going back and forth on the respect track, throwing cards at players, doing drive-bys, using different cards and all that kind of stuff, it does fit really, really well. I enjoy Thug Life. I've played it many times. I've gotten to play with the designer as well, and that was really enjoyable. He's actually from LA, so kind of interesting to play a game with an LA designer. And I haven't seen anybody who has disliked this game since we've been playing it. I've seen people get crazy mad when things happen they don't want to happen. And if you're a kind of player that's going to get mad about certain things, probably not for you. But if you like that and your group is like that kind of take that, screw you kind of thing, you definitely should check out Thug Life. For me, I really do like the game, and I definitely think you should check it out on Kickstarter. In the description below, it's currently up, so go ahead and take a peek at Thug Life. Alright guys, thanks for watching another Unfiltered Gamer Kickstarter board game review. If you like this video, go check out the rest of the videos. If you need to like, subscribe, comment, please like, please subscribe. It's killing my voice here. Just click the button, do that. I don't think you've done it. Alright, fine. As well as checking out Thug Life currently on Kickstarter in the description below. You can get miniatures and all that kind of stuff. I like the variety of different options you have in the game. I personally like miniatures, but I can understand people who don't would just prefer the standees. These are really, really nice. This prototype is beautiful. Anyway, go ahead and also check our website, unfilteredgamer.com. We got tons of new blog posts, giveaways, and Kickstarter lists, as well as I got a bunch of new cool stuff. I got my seal of approval going on. I got my a couple art pieces that have come into the site, so I'm really excited about that. You can also check out everythingboardgames.com and the Giveaway Geek, two great sites with great people in them. I've been working with them for a long time, and I really, really appreciate and I just want to share their wonderful content with you guys. All right, guys, that's all I got for you this time. And as always, I look forward to thugging it up with you next time.